Hello friends, welcome to SST Unitech. My name is Sushil Singh and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. So today I am going to discuss a very common question. Generally interviewer ask this question to us. What is the real-time use of function or store procedure? If we have store procedure in our SQL Server, then what is the requirement for the function? We can done all these things which can be possible in function by using store procedure. Then what is the scenario by which we can use function and we cannot use store procedure? So let's move to another slide where I have created a scenario by which we can get the output by using function, but we cannot get the output by using store procedure. So this is our slide. As you can see, we have input table and we have two output tables. So in input table, we have two columns. First is ID and second is name. In ID, we have integer data and in name, we have alphanumeric data. In our output, you can see we have two tables. First is for the integer value and second is for the string values. So in our first, we want to get the output where we want only integer values are present in name. In our second output, we want only string values are present in our input table. So in our second table, we want to get only string values which are present in name column in our input. So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio where we will discuss how we can get the output. So I am using SQL 2014. You may have another versions of SQL Server, but query would be same for all the versions. So I have already typed the query, so it would save the time. We can create the table. So table has been created successfully, and then I am going to insert some record on it. So 5 rows affected, so 5 rows has been inserted. So this data which I have in this table, and as I have displayed in our slide, both are same. There are 5 rows in our slide, and we have in our input table, we have 5 rows in our input table. So before going forward, I would like to explain about the pat index of string and replace functions. So let's start with pat index. Pat index is very similar to char index. The only difference between pat index and char index, we cannot use wildcard characters in char index, but we can use in pat index. So let's create a scenario by which we can easily understand about the pat index. So select, then we have to specify the pat index and then the search pattern. So what value we want to search? Like we want to search PAK, and then from where we want to search, we have to specify our second parameter. So we want to search from this string. So from this string, we want to search PAK. Now we can execute. We can execute and we can see it's going to return 4. And we can count in our second parameter string D, then double E, then P. So P comes in 4th position. So it's going to return 4. So this is our pat index and it's very easy to understand. So now let's move to substring. So substring function is used to fetch the specific length string from any string. Let's create a scenario by which we can understand about the substring function. So here substring, then expression. So here we have to specify the expression by which we want to fetch the string. Like we have to specify the string. So it's Deepak. And now we can see starting position. So starting position we want 2, and then the length. How many characters we want to get from this string? We want only 2 characters, and then we can execute. Now we can see it start from E and it will pick these 2 characters in our output. So we can see, and it's very easy to understand about the substring function. Move to a replace function. So in replace function, select and then replace, select then replace, and here we have to specify the string by which we want to replace. We want to replace from Deepak. What character we want to replace? I want to replace E. And then from which character we want to replace by T. So close the bracket and execute. So now we can see in our output E has been replaced by T. So these are the 3 functions I have explained here. So now I am going to use all these functions to get the output. So now I have already typed the query. So let's move to our query. So this is our query. So I have declared a variable which is string type,
and I wanna use a loop, and inside this loop I wanna check if the value present in this string variable is not an integer value, because it's going to check between 0 to 9. If the value present in this string variable is not between 0 to 9, then it will return the location of that character value. So inside this loop we can see, so our inner function is pat index. As you can see, this is our inner function. So I gonna explain about this pat index. So pat index is going to return the first non-integer value. So it will return the first non-integer values location. Then I have used this substring function. So in substring function, it will return the first non-integer character, because pat index will return the location where first non-integer value character is present. If it's in first position, then it will return 1. And then in substring function, I gonna use this pat index. So it will start from 1, and we want to fetch only 1 from this. And then our last function is replace function. So replace function is used to replace this non-integer value by blank. Once it would be replaced, then it will again check and then again check until unless value is not only integer. So let's create a function by which we use this formula. So I have already created the function. So this is our function. I gonna execute. So function has been created successfully. And then, so we can use this function as inline function. So this is our table as I have explained. So select star from this table, and then we can see. So execute, and now we can see value is present. We can use this function, and it takes a parameter. So in parameter I wanna use name, and now I wanna execute. So we have to use comma, then dbo dot function name, and now I am going to execute. So here we can see our string value has been replaced by blank, and now I wanna use, so now we can get only integer values from this input string. So we cannot use the store procedure to get the same output in inline query, but in function we can get the inline query. And now as we can see, we have used pat index where this is not equals to, so we can use equals to. Here I wanna use one more function, and now name of this function is get integer value, get string value, and now I wanna replace this not equal to sign. I gonna execute, and we can get the output. So function has been created successfully, and we can use this function over here in our select query, then put comma dbo dot, then the function name, and now we can use name, and now we can execute, and we can see it will return the output. Okay, so there is some mistake I did. We have to alter this function, because we have to replace this not equal to sign over here as well. So now alter this function, and now execute this query, and now we can see we get the output. So this is for integer values, and this is for string values, as I have displayed over here. So one output is for integer, another output for string. So we cannot use store procedures in inline query, but we can use functions in with inline queries. So this is the difference between store procedure and function, where we cannot use store procedure and we can only use functions. I hope you have understand the real time use of function over store procedure. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel for many more videos. If you need this script, it will be available on my Facebook page. You can copy from there. Thank you so much.